There is a loss of jobs in South Africa. In fact, from load shedding to job shedding.
I must call a banker to take you out now.
Brand new from the box, president of the EFF student command at UNILIM Kamogelo Poto. Congratulations to you.
Thank you very much, Tata's my brother.
Yeah.
Elections are over now. Mm-hmm. Students have decided, the organization has decided, we are ready to go and serve students of Limpopo.
Mm-hmm. And you have mopped the floor and proved yet again that the EFF student command is dominant, second to none.
We've been saying it in Teflop that we only know of two things. The first thing we know is students. The second thing we know is EFF Students Command. There's nothing that comes after that. We don't have a position at all in the University of Limpopo. Those who claim to exist are lying to themselves.
It's a walkover, in fact, because I saw during your campaigns, the other chance takers came with their bus or truck, and I saw it leaving before it's the sun sets.
The problem is that you see, when you come with resources of GNU and you don't have the masses on your side, it becomes very difficult. They tried to arrange a bash, but students blue-ticked that bash.
Yes, and despite KFC and T-shirts and all of that.
Students of University of Limpopo are saying, we know our struggles. Mm-hmm. Our struggles are not going to be bought by KFC. Our struggles are not going to be championed by artists. We know our leaders in Teflop, our leaders are in red.
Mm-hmm. All right, let's get the ball rolling. The people of South Africa, Africa and the diaspora, thanks very much for tuning in. This is the EFF Podcast. My name is Titus Tsungurukozera. And today we're coming to you from Winnie Madikizela Mandela House, and we're joined by, brand new from the box, the president of the EFF student command at the University of Limpopo, Kaogelo Poto. Tell us, how did you arrive at cooking these people? I understand you have backed the elections, coming back for third term president. Welcome and congratulations.
No. Thank you very much. You see, my brother, the thing about EFF Students Command, our biggest weakness is that we're very strong. And what I'm trying to say is that you give us an opportunity to lead. We do it to the best of our abilities, to an extent whereby students themselves have even seen that, no, we don't even have to consider anyone else in all these 3 years but EFF Students Command. Yes. So that's what we've been doing. Students Command has led very well in the two previous terms, and then we'll continue with the work in this third term.
Yeah. And what was the strategy for you to, you know, win these elections? I understand the way chance takers were trying to vie for power as well.
Yeah, you see, my brother, you don't win elections on the day of elections. You don't win elections during the season of elections. We won these elections during registration, when we cleared our students free of charge, when we made sure that the students of University of Limpopo are registered without any issues, when we made sure that appeals are attended to in time, when we made sure that allowances are paid in time, when we made sure that our students are well accommodated without paying the rest administration fee.
Yeah.
We made sure that our female students get sanitary towels each and every month without fail. That is a policy of the EFF, where PFF is saying we must give women sanitary towels free of charge. We implemented that in the rest of Limpopo, wherein we gave students who are unfunded food parcels. So this has been an ongoing process whereby we did everything from the beginning of the year up till now. We never failed students, not even with a single issue.
Yeah. As you are ascending to power for the first time, some people may be wondering, who is Kamogelo Poto?
No, Kamogelo Poto is an activist of the EFF and EFF Students Command, born and bred in Zibidiela, Muletlani.
ZB.
Yes, in the province of Limpopo, raised by a single mother who was a domestic worker. Wow. Which to some extent is this thing that shaped us properly to know that this is the real struggle that we're confronted with. And there are many more people out there who are having the same challenges that we have where we come from. Mm-hmm. So, growing up, seeing our mothers struggling, our families struggling to make ends meet, it meant only one thing to us, that we must rise to the occasion and try to change the situation. And when you try to change the situation and then you come across many other people who are like mm-hmm. you are then pushed into the space of politics. We joined EFF mm-hmm. Students Command. And then that's where that we found ourselves politically to say that let's fight for more students or more people who are like us so that we try and better society.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, Kamogelo Poto is just a young boy mm-hmm. from Zibidiela who's obsessed with change.
Mm-hmm. And as the EFF, you know, education is the cornerstone. It becomes, for and foremost, one of the important, components of the organization. Are you studying something? Are you pursuing? What studies are you pursuing?
I'm doing my degree of Bachelor of Education in the University of Limpopo.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, that's what we're trying to pursue.
Yeah. And what sort of draw you into politics? Is there anybody who inspired you? Is there somebody that you look up to in the political space?
You know, when the EFF was introduced, some of us were still in primary school. But I had this love for newspapers. You know, mm-hmm. I always wanted to be informed. We always read about EFF. But what then brought me more into politics
mm-hmm.
was in 2014 when the EFF first was introduced in parliament, seeing the EFF now taking a platform to advocate for the rights of our people, more especially myself as a child of a domestic worker,
mm-hmm.
seeing that people like my mother now represented as the mm-hmm. at a level like parliament.
The attire.
Then we wanted, we followed the politics of EFF, of the commander-in-chief, then we're very obsessed. Now, I remember in high school, I was called Julius.
Oh, okay.
Simply because
yeah.
we're following these things of politics. And mm-hmm. we were trying, even in high school, to be active here and there, but we were suppressed. But our biggest inspiration was our leaders, more especially the commander-in-chief, in how they brought issues of the ordinary masses of our people to parliament.
Mm-hmm. Talking about the ordinary issues that confront the people of South Africa, or rather the issues that confront the ordinary population of South Africa. Now, let's look at the student populace. What are some of the issues that are burning in campus at the University of Limpopo? I understand you also touched on the issues of funding. I understand there's also the Unkhuputiro Trust Fund. If perhaps you can just take us through some of the burning issues and the position of the EFF in trying to address such.
You know, the biggest problem that we have as young people of South Africa is that
mm-hmm.
the doors of higher education are closed, if we are to be realistic.
Mm-hmm.
They are closed in the sense, year in, year out, we have a lot of students who pass their matric, but only a few of them can be admitted into universities.
Mm-hmm.
That means that majority of young people can't access education. Even if all of us were to pass with good grades,
mm-hmm.
not all of us can make it to university.
Yeah.
So that is to say that the challenge we're having in South Africa right now as young people is that the government of the day has failed to give us more universities, has failed to give us more TVET colleges to absorb more young people. But over and above that, the doors of higher education, again, are closed by this systematic challenge of funding, wherein we're told in a way that education is free, but it's a rhetoric because we still have financial exclusions in South Africa.
Mm-hmm.
We still have people whom in January, you see, the reason I'm saying we're clearing people for free, fighting to clear people for free, is because there's no policy existing in South Africa which says there is free education. There's no policy in South Africa that is existing to say that no one must be financially excluded. The poor must access education, especially higher education, for free.
Sure.
So you find children who are coming from poor backgrounds
uh-huh.
being denied education simply because they don't have registration fees. So mm-hmm. those are some of the challenges that we're confronted with in universities. We also have NSFAS challenges. I mean, like just a few months ago, we learned that NSFAS returned over 580 million back to Treasury. And you then ask yourself as a young person, I mean, like, we have so many people that NSFAS defunds, but NSFAS, the same NSFAS takes money, returns it to Treasury. So you see that these people are not taking us serious.
Yeah.
So those are the challenges that we're confronted with. The lack of access to education because we don't have enough institutions of higher learning and the lack of free education in the country.
And University of Limpopo, when it comes to student protest, cannot be spared. We have seen the student taking to the streets over the issues of safety at the University of Limpopo. How far are you in terms of addressing the safety issues?
It's an ongoing matter. Mm-hmm. It has not been addressed. And it's unfortunate, I have to say to you, that 2 months back, we lost one of our students because he was stabbed outside campus going to his room. So what is happening here there in the University of Limpopo is that you'd understand we're situated in Mankwin, and then we have a police station called Mankwin Police Station. That Mankwin Police Station has been going through a renovation, I think, before he was even born. So yes. That
and
police
it's overcrowded.
Station, yes, it's very small. Mm-hmm. And then there's an ongoing construction going there. It even stopped. I think trees have even emerged from that building to stop. So the government of the province or of the municipality, they are failing to increase the capacity of Mankwin Police Station so that you even deploy more vans to that particular place. We have visible patrolling because there's no thug who can rob you when there's visible police patrolling the streets of Mankwin. Mm-hmm. So what we're calling for now as we are trying to address the issues of safety is that let them finish with the construction of Mankwin. Let them deploy more resources, police resources, to the community of Mankwin, because that community is big now. Mm-hmm. It's no longer about the community that originates their own. Mm-hmm. It's about also the 24,000 students that are found there in Mankwin. Mm-hmm. So we're too big for that police station. We're calling on those people in government to really prioritize our matters in terms of deploy more resources of police.
Yeah, you have been campaigning over the past few months and trying to get people to vote for the EFF Student Command, and indeed they have voted you into power. Now, the EFF style, we don't give people empty promises. We make commitments.
Correct.
So from those commitments, what are some of the priorities that you are going to ensure that these commitments are going to be implemented as soon as possible?
We want to call for radical policy transformation in the University of Limpopo, wherein there must be a policy adopted to say that no student must be financially excluded. That is to say that the University of Limpopo, in its own documents, it must write to say that no student must be financially excluded, so that we don't have to fight each year in, year out as the SRC to say that clear these people. We don't want to fight. It must be automatic that they register for free. So because you can't be denied education based on your level of poverty. The other thing that we want to make sure is that we want to build a dynamic relationship between students and workers, and by extension, the community of Mankwin. That is to say that as the EFF Students Command-led SRC, we're not only going to care about the interests of students, but we're going to care about those of our workers, more especially general workers in the university, because those are our parents. Mm-hmm. They may not be my parents biologically, but surely they are students whom they are their parents. Mm-hmm. Those parents of ours, we want to call for the university to insource all of them. All general workers, we want to call for their insourcing. And then this insourcing must not just come and be an insourcing. Mm-hmm. It must come with worker benefits. We want to see them having medical aids. We want to see them having these things of retirement funds. When we speak two-pot system, they must be able to benefit as well.
Yeah.
We want to see these parents of ours, their children, accessing education for free. Mm-hmm. The university must pay for that because these parents of ours are working for that university.
Yeah.
So the other thing that we want to introduce, my brother, because when I say we want to build a dynamic relationship between us as students and the workers of this university, as the SRC that is coming this year, there's a culture of wearing suits, blazers in the university. We are going to eradicate that culture.
Drinking coffee with management.
We are going to air-conditioned
offices.
You understand? We are going to eradicate that culture. We're an SRC now that is coming. We are going to wear overalls each and every day. These overalls must be to say that we are here to serve both you as students and you as workers.
Mm-hmm.
Workers, when they look at us, they must see themselves.
Yeah.
They must see their children who are there to fight for them. These students, when they look at us, they must in a way see that father who comes back from gardening wearing overalls. They must feel comfortable around us as their leaders.
Mm-hmm.
So those are part of the things that we want to do. Well, of course, we want to continue with our program of sanitary towels each and every month. We want to have food parcels for unfunded students each and every month.
Mm-hmm.
The other thing that we want to do, my brother, we want to call for the library to open 24/7.
Mm-hmm.
Because we don't only study during the day. When I wake up at 2 a.m. and feel like studying, I must find the library open.
Yeah.
We want to call for the clinic here there on campus to open for 24/7.
Mm-hmm.
Because this thing of saying that after 4, you can't, it's madness. I mean, like, flu does not have working hours.
Yeah.
We also want to make sure...
It doesn't make an appointment.
It doesn't make an appointment, you're right. And it brings me to the point I wanted to say as I conclude on this matter of saying that our students must book when they are sick. I mean, like, these people, I don't know if they think or what. You know, you're right to say, no, you must book. You are trying to say in your way, in your head, that this flu, when it's going to attack me tomorrow, it's going to say, leader, Pella, tomorrow I'm coming, make something, buy alcoholics. You understand? I must feel sick now and go now and find assistance now.
Yeah.
In a way,
there must be capacity to serve.
We are going to eradicate the system of bookings.
Yeah.
Yes, that's what we are going to do in the SRC.
Mm-hmm. I mean, the spirit of Bantu Steve Biko must be very excited now, and he might be smiling in his grave hearing that black consciousness, in fact, lives and lives on. Now, when we look at the dynamics at the at campus, at UL, not only SASCO that was trying to contest, but there were other political parties. I understand MK was not on the ballot. But are you threatened at all about any other political party, including MK?
I want to say to you, I wish MK was on the ballot. You know, the reason I wish MK was on the ballot, we wanted to demonstrate something.
Your strength, you wanted to flex.
We wanted to demonstrate something to all of them.
Mm-hmm.
You know that...
Combined.
We want them combined. That university, by the way, we're calling for it to be renamed University of Limpopo EFFSC campus. So what is happening here is that we don't have any threat at all, my brother. Because, you know, this MK that you are speaking about, you are speaking of a party that doesn't even have ideologies. They don't even have a constitution. They don't know what they stand for. I mean, like, their leader, their founder, is the same person who denied us free education.
Mm-hmm.
Their leader, their founder, is the same person who arrested our brothers and sisters when they were calling for free education. Abu Kanya Kakeshe were jailed for a very long time for calling for free education. Mafia Fane, our council in Ward 11, in Komazi, was suspended from University of Johannesburg for a lifetime for calling for free education. Abu Amla Mnareng were dealt with systematically. They were brutalized for calling for free education. Naledi Chirwa was dealt with for calling for free education. Abu Vuyani Pambu and this clown of Bongi Nkosi Kanyile. You know, Bongi Nkosi, the reason I'm saying...
Why is he a clown now?
He's a clown because, you know, it's like someone murs you.
Mm-hmm.
And then you still follow them and say, mur me more. Mur, you understand? Because this guy, my brother, he is one of those who were calling for free education.
Mm-hmm.
Was jailed, was criminalized, there's a criminal record now. By the same man that they are following, you understand? So what I'm trying to say to you is that we are not threatened at all as EFF Students Command anywhere, because our party is based on ideology. Our party is based on principles, which all these parties, they do not have. You understand? Our party is based on the ability to serve our students. So we need all of them combined, and we are going to show them what we are going to do.
And you don't need the progressive caucus.
There's no progressive caucus in University of Limpopo. My brother wa cruising nicely alone. We want to be in marriage with students alone.
Mm-hmm.
There's a progressive unity between this EFF Students Command and the students. The rest must unite as clowns, as a and as a unprogressive.
Yeah.
Yes, unprogressive parties.
Yeah.
They will get the same outcomes. They will never defeat EFFSC in the University of Limpopo.
Yeah.
That day, if they defeat EFFSC, I don't know what would have happened, but they will never do it, at least for the next 10 years.
Mm-hmm. And then this one, who just recently joined the MKP and now goes against the EFF policies, Mpumorulane, do you think is one of the people who have betrayed the movement?
You see, my brother, we shouldn't be worried about elements like Mpumorulane. Personally, I've been in a university space for the last 5 years.
Mm-hmm.
I've been in EFF for the past 5 years. We never heard of a guy called Mpumorulane, despite being told that he's the founding president of EFFSC.
Mm-hmm.
After his term of office, there's nothing that Mpumorulane has ever done.
The historical besides, mistake.
Yes, we made a mistake with that guy. Besides being obsessed with the unions, looting money of our workers and other things. So we can't cry over people like Mpumorulane.
Mm-hmm.
His soul had left EFF long time ago. You understand? So these are people that they would say, you see, you know, it's like a person who never joined the EFF trying to say, I'm resigning from the EFF. And we're very happy that SG, Commissioner Marshall Dlamini, responded decisively to that clown. Because how do you resign if you are not a member yet? The guy left EFF long time ago.
Pays 50 rand in advance.
What kind of madness is that? I mean, like, if he feels like the other 30 rand was a donation. His membership was for 2 years. It lapsed a long time ago.
Mm-hmm.
And he never wanted to renew it. He was nowhere found in campaigns of EFF. Even now, with the recent national elections, mm-hmm. we never saw Mpumorulane anywhere on the ground. But these are the same people who want to write us letters and say they are leaving.
Mm-hmm.
Why can't they live in silence? So they are opportunistic. That letter was opportunistic. Even the move to MK is an opportunistic move to say that, let me try and look for bread. Because here in the EFF, we don't have bread, unfortunately. So we really don't ideology. Care about... Yes, we're eating ideology. We don't care about people like Mpumorulane. We are a party that has over 1 million members.
Yeah.
Mpumorulane and his master, Floyd, can live combined. The EFF will still be alive.
Mm-hmm.
That's why even now when they've left, mm-hmm. we're still in charge of University of Limpopo. We're in charge in CUT. We're in charge in TUT.
Yeah.
So they didn't do anything.
Yeah.
Elections are still continuing. Mm-hmm. We'll continue to mob the floor with all of them.
Sure. And talking about elections, President, you'd know that ours is a generational mission. And you'll always remember that it took the ANC 82 years to ascend to power. So there could be people who may look down on the EFF, overlooking at our, you know, overall mandate or mission, which is a generational mission. Going forward, which direction do you think the EFF Student Command should take to ensure that its support base translates into the support base of the EFF mother body, and that support base delivers the EFF in parliament, in government, and in council decisively?
Titus, my brother, the EFF Students Command,
mm-hmm.
Part of its founding principles, it says we must be able to rally students behind the idea of economic freedom in our lifetime. That is to say, we must rally students behind the EFF. And so far, I think we're doing good because if you check results of national elections, we're winning in all campuses. So we need to make sure that we put more efforts in political education.
Sure.
We need to politically orientate our people, even the ordinary ones, of what the EFF is. You know, Commander-in-Chief says it very well in the third NSA in 2019,
mm-hmm.
that... we shouldn't be obsessed with getting into power now because we're going to lose it. What we should be obsessed with is educating our people about what the EFF is so that our people vote for the EFF knowing very well that once we take over power, we're going to expropriate the land. Once we take over power, here are the policies that we're going to implement so that they don't vote for EFF today in the next elections, they want to remove us. Mm-hmm. So we are happy when our people are slowly but surely getting time to know the EFF. Because that is to say, the moment we take over power, our people would, all of them would have a clear consensus of what the EFF needs to do mm-hmm. when it gets to government. Mm-hmm. So we don't have a problem at all with not winning elections now, but we're on a clear mission. Remember that each and every year when we win SRC elections, we deliver a layer of loyal EFF voters, loyal EFF members.
Mm-hmm.
So slowly but surely, we'll reach a point wherein the EFF takes over government.
Mm-hmm.
And once that point is reached, even our people would be appreciating all the 7 non-negotiable cardinal pillars of the EFF.
Mm-hmm.
Our people would not be swayed away by the media. It's funded by Stellenbosch, which seeks to take our people away from the EFF, feed them propaganda always.
Mm-hmm.
EFF is a foreign party. What, you understand? So let us educate our people in campuses, in communities, everywhere, so that they get to appreciate the works that the EFF seeks to do.
Mm-hmm. And talking about educating our people, obviously education is one of our strategic objective to ensure that we deliver economic freedom in our lifetime. Now, when you look at the performance of the EFF Student Command and its existence almost in every campus, in every institution of higher learning in the country, would you then conclude to say the EFFSC, the EFFSC is ready for a youth command? Are we ready to establish a youth command that will go toe-to-toe with our opponents, the ANC Youth League?
I'm surprised they're mentioning ANC Youth League as opponents. I mean, who are they, those ones?
I retract.
And who are they, those ones? Because their president, who was installed by Mbalula, the last time he was in media trying to fight Commander-in-Chief. But you know what happens with people who try to find CIC?
Mm-hmm.
Who try to fight CIC, they all get absorbed into thin air and they are nowhere to be found. So there's no youth league, my brother, that is existing. That is what I want to mm-hmm. to deal with.
Sure.
But there's a serious need for EFF to have a way of mobilizing young people. I don't know if I should say through youth command or what, but remember that leading to the elections, we had what we called Umlungisi Madonsela battalions.
Mm-hmm.
Those Umlungisi Madonsela battalions were able to go deep into rurals, were able to go deep into our townships, everywhere into the suburbs, to say, young people, come out. Let us all go and protect our generational mission of economic freedom. You understand?
Mm-hmm.
So we need to have an arrangement like that. I don't know if they will call it Umlungisi Madonsela a youth brigade, or they will call it EFF Youth Command. But we need to have youth mobilization that is going to go deep into our wards, deep into our communities. Because young people everywhere, they are not mobilized by anywhere. We must be able to rescue young people from nyaope, from alcohol, into politics. Because the reason they are in those things is because of politics. They don't have access to education like I've indicated earlier on. That's why they resort to those things. They don't have access to jobs. It's politics. That's why they resort to those things. So we need to have a political intervention, give them a movement that will keep them busy and occupied. Young people in all spaces of the country must be mobilized through a youth command to say that let us, all of us, call for the agenda of economic freedom in our lifetime. So mm-hmm. we think we're ready as young people. The EFF Students Command is turning 10 next year. So that is to say to you, in these 10 years of existence, we have produced many young leaders who are found in all corners of the country, and they must be able to assist us mm-hmm. in this call to mobilize all young people to rally behind the agenda of economic freedom.
Mm-hmm. And you must be inspired by the decisive victories that have been delivered in Elangeni, in KZN, TUT. We have seen the EFF Student Command coming out strong.
Yes. I mean,
and when is the elections for Univen, is it out already?
No. They are going next month. Okay. We are going to win again that side. So
it's in the bag.
Yes.
In advance.
You know, the one that really made me happy is in Elangen.
Mm.
Some people told us that EFF in KZN is dead.
Mm-hmm.
And young people of Elangen said, not in our name.
Yeah.
You don't lie in our name.
Yeah.
They gave EFFS a clean sweep.
Right in the stronghold of the so-called MK.
Right in the... we shouldn't even say MK. It's not MK that... Right in the stronghold of Ubaba. You know, we have people who are obsessed with Ubaba.
Yeah.
Ubaba was nowhere to be found when EFF Students Command took a decisive victory in Elangen. So that tells you that young people in all corners of the country still resonate with policies of the EFF, still resonate with politics of the EFF, and they just need to be led properly by us as EFF Students Command and the EFF mother body, mm-hmm. to ensure that in all corners we consolidate them into one thing, and then we continue with the mission, mm-hmm. to win elections.
Yeah.
Yes, going to national elections, they were distracted by this. It was just excitement. You know how COPE came into power, how UDM came, mm-hmm. and then later they all died. Mm-hmm. But they will come back. In the next elections, 2026,
yeah.
you will see young people are going to give us all those words, mm-hmm. back from KZN. We go everywhere in the country. We deliver decisive victories.
Mm-hmm. Have you noted the passing of the former minister Praveen Gordhan Jamnandas as the EFF student command at UL?
Yes. We've seen it. Mm-hmm. And we really don't know much about the guy. But the only thing that makes us sad, mm-hmm. is that he died before paying for his sins. He died before being held accountable for selling our state-owned entities. Mm-hmm. I mean, like, we're in load shedding, my brother, because of one man. We were unable to fly to go to anywhere,
mm-hmm.
because he sold Transnet for 51 rands. You understand?
Mm-hmm.
So these are people that we don't want to say that we celebrate their death.
Yeah.
But
death
should have waited a bit. You know, mm-hmm. death should have waited a bit and allowed this man to be held accountable for his actions,
mm-hmm.
so that once he has served his time, when you release him back into society, death says, no, not with our people again. Come here, we're taking you.
Uh-huh.
So, but we've noted the passing of Praveen Gordhan. There's nothing special about him. He died and one not mourning. The entire country is sad because he was not held accountable.
Yeah. I mean, suffice to say, we cannot mourn the death of such characters, because he's known to be a member of an Indian cabal dating back to the 1980s. And this is the same person who persecuted the CIC through the SARS rogue unit.
Yes, yes. Mm-hmm. So, You see, my brother, they always say that lies have short legs. Even these things of conniving against people, they always along the way die.
Yeah.
I mean, like, check from thinking that they've buried Commander-in-Chief. The EFF is this big. Mm-hmm. Commander-in-Chief is this big. Young people love EFF. Young people love CIC.
So everywhere. All over.
Everywhere. Mm-hmm. Instead, the same people who tried to destroy the leader of this generation.
Yeah.
Ended up destroying society, because they couldn't destroy him, and he had to come back through the EFF, fight for us again, you understand?
Mm-hmm.
And then he fought even against them, Abu Praveen, to say that these things of privatization of Eskom, SAA, they are wrong,
mm-hmm.
you understand? So they tried to destroy him, they failed.
Mm-hmm.
They failed this man. That's why I'm even saying that we can't mourn the death of Praveen. Well, unlike the opportunists, PAC, who are saying, I'm sure.
I mean, those ones were part of the GNU. They're compromised.
I'm sure Robert Sobukwe is turning in his grave to say, this guy, you see. So, Jamnanda's dying really has nothing to do with us as the EFF. The only thing that we're disappointed at is that he was not held accountable for his actions. Mm-hmm. You understand? But we really don't care. He dies, he lives, we didn't care.
Mm-hmm.
What we are focused with now, we are focused on making sure that all state entities are not privatized and they are well-resourced so that they continue to take care of our people. We want to make sure as the EFF that we fight till there's no blackout, because now they gave load shedding a new name, but it's a blackout. Mm-hmm. Till there's no blackout at all,
yeah,
we want to make sure that Eskom is able to maintain it, sustain itself. SAA is able to sustain itself. Denial must be brought back, be that super house that it was, you mm-hmm. understand? Mm-hmm. So we need more of the state entities that Praveen had destroyed mm-hmm. to come back to life mm-hmm. now that he has exited life.
Yeah, and the president of the Republic of South Africa, Cyril Ramaphosa, is due to sign the Bella bill into yes. law. And we have the likes of the Democratic Alliance who have threatened to leave the GNU should, you know, Ramaphosa signs that bill into law. And already their Minister of Basic Education has not attended a parliament. And we understand that once signed into law, this bill will advance the struggles of a black child forward, because we understand the promotion of African languages will be upheld.
Yes, yes. Mm-hmm. You know, we're not surprised when racist parties like DA
would
go publicly and say, we reject the Bella Bill. Mm-hmm. You understand? These are people who don't care at all about black people. These are people who want to ensure that the black skin is forever sidelined. You understand? Uh-huh. So we're not surprised at all. But unfortunately, the Bella Bill will be put into law with or without them. We don't need the racists to tell us what is good for our children in schools. Mm-hmm. We don't need these racists to tell us what must happen, what must not happen. The Bella Bill is a progressive bill that will ensure that black people, not black people only, but all of us mm-hmm. in this country were equal. Mm-hmm. You understand? Mm-hmm. And we want to say that as the Bella Bill has been signed into law, we want to also call for education to be standardized. There must not be this thing of IEB.
Mm-hmm.
The education of South Africa must all fall under the basic education, the Department of Basic Education. Mm-hmm. That is
not
to say,
standards.
We don't want that. Mm-hmm. Because the moment you give, why are you having private education for the rich and then this education for us, the poor? It simply means we still have that Bantu education that Steve Biko fought against, that Nkopo Tsetiro fought against, you understand? So as the Bella Bill is going to be signed into law, which we support properly, mm-hmm. we are also calling for education to be standardized so that all of us have access to equal education. We want the same education, all of us. Because what is it that you are teaching Van der Walt there, which you can't teach Kekan?
Yeah,
you understand?
Sure.
So we need our people to be taught the same thing as those children of white people.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, I wish it can be made into law that there must be no private school that exists without 40% of the children in that school mm-hmm. coming from poor backgrounds and not paying, so that all of us are mixed mm-hmm. in one school. We want to go to this boys' high. We want to go to this girls' high and be with them properly. But otherwise, we welcome the Bella Bill.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to ensure that our African languages, like you've said, are well catered
mm-hmm.
in all spheres.
Mm-hmm.
We want our people in Cape Town to be taught Xitsonga. We want our people in deep in Orania
mm-hmm.
to be taught in Spain.
Sure.
So those are the things that we want, and then we really welcome the bill.
Mm-hmm. And what do you think should be the function of NFSAs going forward? Because year in, year out, we understand there are issues of late payments, of allowances, be it for food, be it for transport, be it for accommodation.
We want NFSAs to be scrapped. We want total free education, wherein the state must take charge. The state must be the one that directly pays our fees to universities. The state must be the one, when it pays the fees, when it pays the bills, it must also send our allowances straight to universities so that we get this thing. We don't want this middleman of NSFAS, because it forever gets infiltrated
mm-hmm.
by questionable characters like your causa who was removed there.
Because mm-hmm.
these people come there, they collapse NSFAS. Like last you've seen, they try to take NSFAS, even give it to private companies in terms of Izaga,
mm-hmm.
Trying to make more money for themselves. Yeah. So, but
they want to squander the resources.
Yes, yes, yes. Because now we're still stuck with this NSFAS that we don't believe in.
Mm-hmm.
We're calling for it to be decentralized. We want NSFAS to have offices in all provinces. Because it doesn't make sense for NSFAS to be far, far, far from us in Limpopo and then be based in Cape Town. I mean, like when we have issues, we must be able to travel to their provincial offices. 30 minutes, we arrive there, we say, here are concerns of University of Limpopo. They resolve them and release the allowances. So mm-hmm. we are calling for NSFAS to be decentralized in the immediate when we don't have this NSFAS being dissolved.
Mm-hmm.
We want it to be decentralized. It must have offices in each and every province. Because if it does not do that, my brother, some of the challenges that we are faced with is that you will go to a financial aid in university. They say to you, NSFAS hasn't sent the funding list.
Mm-hmm.
And it takes so long. They will take 2 months, 3 months to send your funding list. I mean, the status is saying you are funded, but to update the funding list, they will take 3 months. So if we had their offices here close by with us, we're just going to go there properly with our overall and boots, stand on top of their tables. We're not living here until you fix this issue.
Yeah.
But now we're unable to do so because we're poor. Mm-hmm. We can't arrive in Cape Town.
Mm-hmm.
They take advantage of us because we can't arrive in Cape Town. They know that if we close these tabs, we don't give them the funding list, they will continue to suffer in those institutions and they will not do anything to us because they can't mobilize mm-hmm. and come and protest. They were far from them.
Mm-hmm.
We need them next to us.
And
the other thing we're calling for is that NSFAS must have its employees in all campuses, at least 2 per campus, so that when we need immediate assistance with appeals, with changing of statuses, we go to the relevant person there, we say, you are a person responsible in NSFAS, give us 1, 2, 3, they give us immediately.
Mm-hmm. And now we understand the EFF Student Command has embarked on a 100,000 membership campaign drive. How is it going? Are you reaching your targets at the University of Limpopo?
University of Limpopo is the first campus, by the way, to reach the target. We have surpassed our target.
Mm-hmm.
And then we want to continue to mobilize even beyond the targets that we've been given. Because what we want at the end of the day, everyone to be politicized
mm-hmm.
in the University of Limpopo, including all students. At least we want 50% of them
mm-hmm.
to be members in good standing of EFF Students Command mm-hmm. and EFF.
Mm-hmm.
That is to say that in the 24,000 students that we have, we want 12,000 of them to be members of EFF and EFF Students Command. It's not going to be an easy task, but we're still going to continue engaging
mm-hmm.
in a mobilization. It's a very good initiative, this thing of 100,000 membership of EFFSC, because mm-hmm. it's the one that is going to make sure that at the end of the day, students are rallied behind the banner of economic freedom in our lifetime.
Mm-hmm. And talking about students rallying behind the banner of the EFF and the EFFSC, We know that year in, year out, the EFF Student Command assists thousands of students who seek registration fees and who seek to further their studies with, you know, registration, you know, funding them through if they have any financial backlogs or challenges through the Sizo Funda Ngenkane campaign. So if we can just look at the campaign itself, what progress have you made through the Sizo Funda Ngenkane campaign, and looking ahead of 2025 academic year, what are the plans in place to ensure that no student is left behind?
The first thing I would like to do, I want to thank President Peter Kietz for giving us the Sizo Funda Ngenkane campaign. This campaign has been a campaign that ensured that many of us access education free of charge, forcefully so, because Ngenkane, you understand. So even us sitting here, we are products of Sizo Funda Ngenkane. If Sizo Funda Ngenkane was never there, our parents wouldn't have paid for our fees. They don't have that thing. So the Sizo Funda Ngenkane campaign has been able to assist, yes, thousands of students across the country to access education free of charge. It is going to continue even in 2025. We're going to make sure that no student is left behind and no student pays a single cent to register, more especially in the University of Limpopo. We have a responsibility as the SRC now. And if we don't fulfill that responsibility, we are saying it here that the EFF must expel us. We have the responsibility of ensuring
Your head on the block.
Yes, we are having a responsibility of ensuring that all black people, because we are the ones who are suffering. I'm saying this because we are the ones who are suffering. All black people who come to institutions of higher learning must be able to be assisted free of charge. We are going to make sure that come 2025, there's no student who comes and is academically deserving that is going to be turned back. Well, if it means we must surpass our own targets as the university in terms of how many people can we register, let it be like that. Because what is the meaning of closing it to 24,000 if we can take 30,000 because we're attending online? So we want to make sure that everyone who comes there and is academically deserving gets admitted and is registered for free. Because it is only through this Zofuna Ngenkani that we are going to be able to fight this poverty. We are going to be able to fight unemployment. Because, you know, the mind that is educated is able to, even when the government is not creating employment for us, is able to be creative and come up with something and create employment for themselves and others, you understand? So we value education very much in the EFF, and that is why we're going to make sure that even the next Zofuna Ngenkani is a success and this time around assists even more people than we ever previously assisted.
So for students who seek assistance, how do you assist them? Because I understand universities, most recently, they did not allow walk-ins. They would say, go online, apply. Sometimes students do not have data. So how do you go about assisting students who need assistance at this point in time?
So what we are personally going to do with this SRC of ours, we are going to take our offices for that duration of registration and station them outside the campus. We don't. Why should we sit in offices inside the campus when our students are not allowed to enter campus? So what we're going to do, we're just going to take that furniture in those offices of ours. We sit in all the gates of University of Limpopo to ensure that our people, when they come, we're able to assist them properly. If the management doesn't want them on campus, it's fine. Let them keep their campus. But we're going to be with our people outside the campus. But me saying this, we're going to be with them, does not mean that we're not going to fight for those gates to be forcefully opened. The gates must be forcefully opened. The people who come from as far as Messina, who come from as far as Makado and everywhere, must be able to come, do walk-ins, because we understand that our students are unable to register, to apply online, yet they pass. Because where we come from in the villages, my brother, is tough. You find that you have to apply, you don't even know what is a website. You are told to apply, you don't know what is a website. You don't even know how to buy data, you understand? Or even if you know, you don't have money to buy data. So those people who have passed and have, did not get chance to apply must be able to come to University of Limpopo. We will assist them. We're saying it here without any fear of contradiction that we will have walk-ins either their way, either with our way that we prefer of saying students must be in campus, or again with our way of saying that we are going to take our offices and station them at the gates.
Yeah.
Because we're not going to be inside the campus when there's no one. We're not made people. We can't sit there with no one.
And over the past years, with looking at the tenure of the VC, Prof. Mohalong, has it been a listening management? Does he heed the call of students when you take to the streets and demand? I remember one of the demands was that in relation to safety, that there must be street lights on campus, and they should make sure that there is visibility, you know, and the security as well within campus must be able to do those patrols. Are you happy at all with the conduct of the management, particularly that of the VC, Prof. Mohalo?
You see, my brother, as we go into the SRC, we are going to check his conduct properly. We are going to check his conduct properly. And then when we go there, we want to say it here that the EFF is a protest movement. the FFSC, by extension, is a protest movement. Mm-hmm. We're going to have our own approaches of making things to happen. So if we go and we engage you properly at first hand, then you are then going to give us issues as the VC. We'll be left with no other choice but to do what we do best. And what we do best is to mobilize students and make sure that you listen to us by force. Mm-hmm. That is to say that we will protest and make sure that we get what we want. So we're new in office. We're yet to meet the VC and discuss issues with him. And then his response to our demands will determine what is the approach that we take.
Mm-hmm.
But should it be an arrogant approach, Frantz Fanon teaches us what to do. That violence must be responded to with violence.
Yeah.
And then arrogance equally will be responded to with arrogance.
Mm-hmm.
Meaning that if we go to his office and he fails to resolve issues of students, we have our own offices in the streets.
Yeah.
He will call, we will be called
yeah.
to our offices mm-hmm. in the streets, wherein he must come, will be surrounded by our students
mm-hmm.
and he must speak to us there.
Yeah.
Because he would have failed to agree with us mm-hmm. in his office.
Yeah. So just a disclaimer, ladies and gentlemen, this is not a threat. We're not threatening any violence, but it is just in our nature. The EFF is a protest movement. So we are likely to see a lot of challenges being addressed in your tenure, President, as you take over the reins.
Yes, yes.
Mm-hmm.
So, yes, we are going to try and address a lot of challenges that we have in the University of Limpopo.
Mm-hmm.
The first one that I want to say is that I know students of University of Limpopo know that this has been a challenge for them. There's this policy which they call 75% attendance rule,
mm-hmm.
which says if you don't attend 75% of your classes, you are not going to write.
Mm-hmm.
I want to say it here on the EFF podcast,
mm-hmm.
where our commander-in-chief is situated, to say that that policy will never work for as long as EFF Students Command is still in office.
Mm-hmm.
All of you students of University of Limpopo, you are going to write your examinations with or without 75%. Even if it includes you, even if it means that you have 0% attendance, you must write your examinations. Because to write examinations, my brother Titus, mm-hmm. it can never be gauged by whether or not you are coming to class. If I'm passing my test and I qualify very well for examinations,
yeah.
why should you tell me about attendance?
Yeah. An exam can moor you even if you attend every day.
You understand? are they trying to say that if you have 100% attendance
yeah.
and you are failing, are you smarter than me
no,
who has 0% attendance, but I'm passing? So
yeah.
we are going to gauge students based on their marks, not their attendance. The other issue that we want to address is the functional of a S-Block. S-Block mm-hmm. has many errors. S-Block is our financial aid office.
Mm-hmm.
It would give sometimes students double allowances, not give others allowances. So the first thing we're going to do, the first people we're going to visit when we enter office properly, we're going to visit S-Block.
Mm-hmm.
S-Block must be visited to ensure that they stop with this financial maladministration of theirs. And that office must be able to administer finances of our students properly.
Mm-hmm.
Because if you give me double allowance now in September, my brother Titus, mm-hmm. you are trying to say that you already gave me an allowance of November in advance. Mm-hmm. Who's going to give me that allowance in November? Mm-hmm. You understand? If you are now making your list of making payments, then you say you missed me by mistake also, and then you don't give me money. Who must pay my rent for that month? Who must pay my meals for that particular month? So this is another issue that we are going to fight. Then over and above that, the other issue that we want to fight is the issue of NSFAS appeals.
Mm-hmm.
NSFAS has approved many appeals of our students, but till today, they haven't been given any allowance. These appeals were approved 3 months ago,
mm-hmm.
simply because NSFAS is saying we don't have a funding list. We want to say that we are going to make sure that we fight NSFAS with everything we have.
Mm-hmm.
We are going to summon them to University of Limpopo so that we fight them. If they don't come to University of Limpopo,
yeah.
we will go to where they are.
Mm-hmm.
We know their office in Cape Town. We will go there with our overalls and boots properly and fight them to ensure that our students at the end of the day get what they deserve,
mm-hmm.
which is their funding. So these are just the minor issues that we have and we should be able to address.
Yeah.
The rest we've addressed in our previous term.
Sure. And talking about the previous term, what will be different from this current leadership of the SRC from the previous SRC leadership, what will set you apart from your predecessors?
Some of us were ground forces, were grounded. You see, the mistake that they made there in the University of Limpopo is that they elected a ground force into office. I don't like sitting in office watching
a conditioned
things.
Office.
Understand? You understand? So
yeah,
we're saying that what is going to be different is that with us, the streets and the ground is going to know us more than office chairs.
Yeah.
In fact, they can log those offices of theirs and not give me the keys the entire time. I will operate from the streets because that's where our students are found.
Yeah.
I will operate from the streets of campus, from the ground where we normally meet with our students. So our SRC is going to be characterized by the ability to be radical. And being radical, I'm trying to say that we are going to resolve issues, big or small. And then these issues are going to resolve them by any means necessary, even if it includes protesting and closing
the campus.
By hook
or by crook?
We really don't mind. We've yeah. done that before when we were not in power. Why can't we do it now?
Mm-hmm.
So if issues can be resolved, certain things must be stopped somewhere.
Yeah.
This is not a threat to anybody, but we're just saying that we have that ability of closing the campus
yeah.
if they're not agreeing to us.
Mm-hmm.
And should we be forced to do that, we'll do it.
Yeah. So as we wind up this interview, what is the mood on campus after you have won the elections? And what is the program? Are you going to organize something to thank the voters? Normally, when the EFF has done, after the elections, it does the Siyabonga rally. Is there anything that you have planned to thank the voters of the EFF Student Commander?
We want to really appreciate students of University of Limpopo very much. We're in engagements now with our leadership to say that these students of University of Limpopo gave us 1,600 votes in the last government, in the last national elections,
mm-hmm.
where in ANC only got 200 in that VD.
Mm-hmm.
They came again, this University of Limpopo students, to give us more than 7,700 votes in the SRC elections. So if you don't thank such people, they will think that you don't appreciate their efforts, you don't appreciate their votes.
Mm-hmm.
So we are planning something for them. We want our shita twerker
yeah.
at the University of Limpopo.
Is so it a bash or what?
We want a proper bash.
Yeah.
We twerker properly
yeah.
with our people. You know, when I say this, I don't mean literal twerker, but there's a language in Limpopo, you see. We have a shit.
Yeah.
When we're going to say shita. We twerker with our students to say to them,
thank you
very much, because we really are nothing as EFF Students Command without these students of ours.
Mm-hmm.
And if we don't thank them enough,
mm-hmm.
they will end up going to these ones who are opportunistic.
Yeah.
So yeah, we're arranging something proper for them. We will dance.
Sure. And going into the EFF NPA in December, what sort of leadership, the character of the leadership that you think should take the movement forward? We have previously seen people that we thought were loyal to the organization but jumping ship. We have learned quite a lot in terms of the character and how should a leader conduct themselves through the CIC. What sort of leadership do you think the conference in December should elect into power?
We really are praying that the conference elects ground forces, elects activists.
Mm-hmm.
Because when you elect activists and ground forces, you are able to have people who are grounded in communities, leading the masses with the masses. Not people who are going to be leading from far, not grounded anywhere, then mm-hmm. they're not doing anything. So we want people who are going to appreciate the 7 non-negotiable cardinal pillars of the EFF. We want people who are going to really make sure that this EFF of ours is radical, it's militant in approach with everything. We want people who are going to make sure mm-hmm. that the EFF is robust in engagements when engaging on issues.
Mm-hmm.
We want people who are going to make sure that the EFF continues to be the protest movement, continues to be the vanguard and the fighting tool in the hands of the poor and dejected masses of our people. So what we are trying to say is that we want people who are going to bring back that culture of EFF, of making sure that each and every year when it starts, we identify a program of action and we go and fight. We have done it before with Zuma Must Fall. We have done it before with saying that it is the year against the racist financial sector.
And through the shutdown, the national shutdown.
You understand? Mm-hmm. We have done it before when we're shutting down, fighting for our people to have lights. Mm-hmm. So we want that kind of leadership, which is not only going to say that the GNU is failing, but which is going to confront all these offices, all these departments, in a way of a ground forcism, wherein we are going to take our people, we protest. We want the EFF to be that protest movement, because that is what attracted us to this movement. And that is what makes the ordinary masses of our people feel, fall in love with the EFF, because they will be feeling represented.
Yeah. All right. So your current composition of the SRC, you know, the issues of gender parity comes forth and is very important in the EFF.
Yes, yes.
Have you tried to balance, you know, gender issues when, you know, assembling your cabinet, so to speak?
You know, it's not only about balancing gender.
Mm-hmm.
It's about bringing capable women into leadership.
Mm-hmm.
And we can safely say that out of the 11 seats that we have five women who are occupying positions of leadership. And they are not just occupying unstrategic positions. We have three females who are in the executive of five people. So that is to say that we appreciate women leadership in the EFF, and we have confidence in women leadership. So the gender issue shouldn't even be a question. That is my must. It must be done, because we have capable women in the EFF, and we are not threatened by women leadership. We are not like those who denied Winnie Mandela to be president of this country because she was a female. Mm-hmm. We are not like those who denied Winnie Mandela the opportunity to lead because she was a female and they felt threatened. Mm-hmm. In the EFF, we appreciate women leadership.
Yeah.
I mean, like, even in the EFF motherboard, we have three out of five in the leadership, in the officials of the EFF. So we're drawing inspiration there to say that we're seeing these women, they're leading as well, they're capable. That's why even in campus, we're bringing it like that to say that because executive is five, we can't have three males, we want three females who are capable to lead our students.
So what is the warning shot that you are giving to those that try and contest the EFF as this 2024-2025 election season continues? Vets, I think it's coming, and other chance takers, what sort of warning shot are you giving to them?
If they love themselves, they must just withdraw and focus on books and other things, because the level of embarrassment that is coming, it's beyond imaginable. So the EFF Students Command is going to win in all campuses. That we can say it for free here. We are not threatened by anybody. In the Limpopo, we have already won two. We are going to win UNILIM in October. So these people, if they love themselves and they love their health, they care about their health, they must really think twice about contesting. So, but the EFF Students Command is coming. It is the darling of the masses on the ground, the darling of students, because this is a party that never failed students in all corners of the country. So we will win. And the only message we have for them, these clowns of GNU and MK, we want to say to them that please be prepared. The Red Army is coming to take everything. When I say be prepared, even if they prepare, they are still not going to win.
Buckle up.
So it's done, my brother.
Yeah.
EFFSC will win in all campuses.
Mm-hmm.
Because, you see, young people can't be bought by anything. There's no amount of KFC that will rescue the
South.
There's no amount of T-shirts that will rescue these people. We are going to win elections without resources, because the only resource we have is ideology, is principle, is the ability to serve mm-hmm. when we're in governance.
Yeah.
And our students appreciate that very much.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't matter whether you call DJ Titus or you call who.
It's
not going, Titus won't assist you to win elections, you understand?
Mm-hmm.
So our students know very well that even if SASCO can throw mm-hmm. the biggest bash in the entire country, that bash is not going to resolve their issues on the ground.
I'm not a DJ, guys. So, yeah, I'm the host and a member of the EFF in good standing.
Sure.
Now,
oh, you renewed your membership.
I did. Did you? Sure. Did you renew yours?
We've renewed our membership. When they called and said it's expiring, we said, please give us 2 more years. Then now that we're here at Winnie Mandela House, we want to ask for lifetime membership.
Yeah.
We want to really be members of this EFF.
Yeah.
So we want to say to the EFF that if the EFF will be remaining with 2 or 1 member,
mm-hmm.
it will be us. Mm-hmm. So the EFF is the only thing we know politically. We started politics with the EFF. We are going to die in the EFF with the commander-in-chief.
Mm-hmm.
The commander-in-chief must know that he's not left alone, but he's left with ground forces, he's left with young people, he's left with thinkers mm-hmm. who are going to die wherever he dies.
Yeah.
Before they kill the commander-in-chief, they will have to kill us first.
Mm-hmm.
And if they don't kill us, we will kill them.
Yeah.
So we're going to win and be government together in the EFF.
Mm-hmm.
That we're not going anywhere.
Mm-hmm. And when I just renewed mine. I was just looking for my membership card, but I can't find it. But I've renewed my membership. But let me take this opportunity to convey my heartfelt gratitude for you coming through, President, and congratulations. And we really wish you all the best going forward. We know that the EFF leaders don't make empty promises, but they commit and do what they say they will do within the set time frame. So thank you very much for coming through. I really hope that the students of Limpopo will now be taken care even much better under your leadership.
No, thank you very much, leadership.
Yeah, and let's look at the song of the day, the song that you want us to play as you drive all the way or you fly all the way to, to Limpopo.
We're going to take lifts. We don't have anything. So
yeah, so what the song that will take you back to the University of Limpopo?
There's a song that just that it's not in the EFFSC our just hour,
mm-hmm.
but the song says "Kuse Kayala."
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
"Kuse
Kayala." We want to say to everyone that EFF is our permanent political home.
Mm-hmm.
So with that being said, we just want to reaffirm to everyone.
We're
not going anywhere. Kuse Kayala.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But from the EFF just hour, you can give us a uligwagwa.
Uligwagwa.
Yes.
All right. No, we'll definitely give you uligwagwa. And the message is really clear. There's no EFF student command leader or student who are going to be hoodwinked through T-shirts and KFCs. The only currency towards economic freedom is the ideology of the EFF. Ligwagwa, thank you very much, President, for coming through. So we have come to the end of the show. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for tuning in. We really appreciate your viewership as always. And remember to subscribe to the EFF YouTube channel for more content. So my name is Titus Tsungu. Until we meet again. Chuchu commander.